Dunes are an accumulation of sand grains. Sand dunes form when wind carries sand up the beach and deposits it in a heap around an obstacle, like a piece of driftwood, vegetation, or even a dead bird. Aeolian processes are the action of wind. Sand will not be moved until the wind reaches a velocity fast enough to move the particles of sand. We call this velocity the fluid threshold velocity. Large particles require higher wind velocity to be moved than finer particles. However, in wet climates, sand particles are more difficult for wind to pick up, as wet sand tends to clump together. Sand moves by surface creep, which is sand rolling along the ground, the suspension of smaller particles in the air, or by saltation. The process of saltation involves particles being lifted by a small distance in the air, only for them to fall back to the surface under the force of gravity and strike other sand grains. The grains that are hit by the saltating grains are then forced by kinetic energy to move themselves. If there is a drop in wind velocity, deposition will occur. Dunes classically have a gradual upwind slope and a steep downward slope. Dunes are especially steep in places where they've been eroded by a stream, such as this example here at Bethel's Beach. Sand dunes don't form anywhere. They require special conditions to form. Firstly, dunes require an abundant supply of sediment. Beaches and deserts are examples of environments where vast amounts of loose sediment exist. Muriwai has an abundance of fine black sand, mixed in with white sand that originates from an earlier era. Secondly, dunes require ample wind energy to be able to pick up sand grains and transport them. However, it is important that particles are small enough for aeolian erosion and transportation to take place. Muriwai certainly ticks this box with an average wind speed of 15 knots. Thirdly, beaches with large tidal ranges are more likely to have dunes, as there's more time for sand to dry out enough for wind to pick up the grains. Muriwai, with its gentle sloping gradient and 3 meter tidal range, easily fits this criteria. And finally, dunes require an ideal location for sand to accumulate. Muriwai, for instance, has an extensive backshore area where sand can accumulate. You don't find dunes at places like Maori Bay, where there are cliffs preventing the inland spread of sand.